हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश सेशन। सो इन टुडे सेशन वी गोइंग टू सी अ पोएम एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम इज द विलेज स्कूल मास्टर एंड द पोएट इज ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट डज द पोएट सेज इन दिस पोएम। About poet, Oliver Goldsmith was born in Longfield and was educated at the Trinity College, Dublin. He was awarded the degree of Doctor of Medicine, but he never practiced as a doctor. His major works are The Traveller, 1764, Vicar of Wakefield, 1766, The Deserted Village, 1770, and She Stoops to Conquer, 1773. This extract gives a character sketch of the village schoolmaster who taught the villagers there. It also gives an account of the views of the children and of the villager of Auburn about the schoolmaster. So this is about a poet. So let's look into the glossary. This poem gives a character sketch of the village schoolmaster who taught the villagers there. It also gives views of the children and the villagers about the schoolmaster. It is one of the best known poems of the 18th century. First stanza. Beside yon straggling fence that skirts the way with blossomed furs unprofitably gay, there in his mansion skilled to rule, the village master taught his little school. So here, poem starts with a description of location of the school. The village schoolmaster runs his little school in a small village. The school is situated next to an irregular fence and also leaning over. The road leading towards the school is lined with flowers which are not being admired or appreciated by the people. The school is mentioned as a noisy mansion following the rules of the schoolmaster. Village teacher is equipped to manage a class and teaches his lesson here. So here in this we have learned, as explanation I have given you, that the school was residing, a location was somewhere where the place was not so good. Okay, the place was not so good, and it was outside the village, where you can see different kinds of flowers, but those flowers were not so attractive. And he had a small school. He had a small school which is called as a mansion, and that is where the schoolmaster used to teach the lesson to the children. And he was not a profitable guy. That means there were very less children, but still he used to enjoy his work teaching the children. A man stiff he was and stern to view. I knew him well and every taunt knew. Well had the bonding tramblers learned to trace the day's disaster in his morning face. So in second stanza, we understand that he is very much strict teacher. He was a very strict teacher, and when people used to see him, when people used to observe him, he used to look very strict. Okay, the speaker says that here, the poet says that he and all other trons know him well because they have undergone the master's range. So here the speaker or the poet says that we all know him very well. The villagers or the students know him very well because we all have gone through him for the master. That is, he has taught us here, whoever in the village. Okay, and the students have learned to sense the mood of the teacher by observing his face. So here the poet says that the students have learned too much. The, you know, even you have, right? You see your teachers, you see your parents' mood. and then you talk to them, right? So here the students have learned and learn to sense the mood of the teacher by observing his face, and the people or the students is to say the day's trouble is noticed from his forehead. So if you see the day, if you see his face with a disaster, if you see teacher's face with an angry one or with his bad mood, that means the whole day will be turned into a disaster. So always when students see his face, it's not a disaster, but when students understand that he's in a very bad mood or he's not in a good mood, he's upset kinda, that means the morning if you see that face, that means whole day is going to trouble you. Third stanza. Full well they laughed with counterfeit glee at all his jokes, for many a joke had he. Full well the busy whisper circling round conveyed the dismal tiding when he frowned. So here the poet says, the schoolmaster is an contradiction. Although he's strict, he's kind, and he's also good humored. He tells many jokes to the students. Whenever he tells some jokes, the children laugh with his pretended joy. That means they laugh too much. If they have noticed any sign of anger on his face, they will spread the news throughout the classroom. Okay, if they see that sir is very angry, so this news will be spread out throughout the classroom. Each student will come to know that he is very much angry. But basically, the schoolmaster is a kind man. If at all he has any fault, it is because of his intense love for learning. So here he says, poet says that if he is angry also on the student, because the schoolmaster wanted that each and every children has to learn something. The next stanza. Yet he was kind, or of several in aught. The love he bore to learning was in fault. The village all declared how much he knew. It was certain in put right. So here, the poet says that the schoolmaster was admired and respected by the villagers. Okay, why they used to respect? Because villagers used to praise him because he had a great knowledge. He had a great knowledge. And also he had the love towards the learning. Okay, he always wanted to learn something. Okay, and villagers always used to praise him that how much he knew. And also he the villagers says that he can write, he can read, and he can write so many things. That means the schoolmaster was educated, well educated, and he know very well about the learning. So this is how the villagers used to praise schoolmaster. Lands he could measure, terms and ties presage, and even the story ran that he could gauge. In arguing too, the person owned his skill, for even though vanished, he could argue still. So here the poet says that he can write, he can do mathematics, and even he can predict the weather patterns. Okay, he can also tell how the climate is going to be. It is also assumed that he can do accurate survey and determine borders easily. The villagers used to say that he can find out exact survey, and he also can debate with the people, with the villagers, very brilliantly. Okay, a person who was greatly respected by his villagers. The schoolmaster, okay, here the schoolmaster, even he used to argue with the people, okay, and he used to argue in such a way where the other person has to automatically say that we have lost. So while arguing also, he will put his 100% of knowledge and he will argue with the person. The last stanza. While words of learned length and thundering sound amaze the gazing rustic ranked around, and still they gazed and still the wonder grew, that one small head could carry all he knew. So here the poet says the villager used to get amazed. They used to get surprised. Okay. Why did they get surprised? Because the way he used to argue, the way the schoolmaster used to argue with the opposite people, opposite person, okay? He is to use some lengthy and some lengthy words, okay? Some lengthy letters or lengthy words he is to use, and he is to say, he is to argue in a thundering sound. Thundering sound is nothing but in a bold sound, okay? Bold sound. And people used to get amazed, people used to get surprised that how come he is using so bold letters, how can he speak so boldly, how can he use so big letters, right? Big words he can use. And here people used to still see like how it is possible. The master used difficult words and emotional languages to convince and impress the poorly educated village people. So here he should teach them how he should use the hard words, difficult words, so that he can educate the people. The person also accepted the master's skill in debate. So when he is to debate with the other person, so when person, the other opposite person, when he is to learn, he is to listen to the master, he used to amaze, he used to feel happy, okay? And sometimes sometimes what happened, when the opponent is losing the debate, even if he used to feel happy because he is learning something new. But here the villagers used to get one doubt. What doubt he used to get? They used to get it's a small head. It is a small head of village master, and it carries so many things in the brain. Okay, he know everything, right? So people used to amaze, like, he have a small brain, but see how much he knows about the knowledge. So as we have done with the stanzas, it's a quick summary. As we understood, the poet is remembering his teacher, and he's telling how my school village, how my village teacher was there, right? And though the poem presents a pleasant remembrance of the poet about the schoolmaster, the poem ends in a sad tone. So he remembering that how my schoolmaster was, right? For the two last lines tell the present condition. The great fame of the schoolmaster has becoming a thing of past. It was a past, it was a beautiful remembrance, but now it has become a past. At present, the school where he faces many successes, forgotten. So at present the school has turned into a big mansion, but now they have all forgotten the schoolmaster's effort. So here we remember sometimes our school teachers, right? That they have, we say that our teacher was good one, they have taught us so many things. So here also the poet remember his teacher's effort, and he remembers him, he praise him, and he says that my schoolmaster had taught us very good things, and now at present we are staying here, I am able to be in this condition only because of my schoolmaster. So I hope you understood this poem. It's an easy poem. Go through the poem and see you in the next session. Bye bye.